Hello. How old do you think I am?
18.
Okay. But if you hadn't been told my age, how old do you think I was? Maybe 20? 25? On my birthday, a lady at KFC said, "You look like you're turning 28. And that was this year. Ladies and gentlemen, today I am dressed. I have headphones on my neck, I have a hat on my head, and I have kikoi pants. They're very instrumental for my talk. Please pay keen attention. And lastly, ladies and gentlemen, I am a millennial. In fact, most people today on Instagram are millennials. Most people looking at memes are millennials. And most people who are probably going to be watching this talk might be millennials. So I'd like to tackle these two questions. What is a millennial? And what does that really mean? So there's a nice anagram. Who millennials are? Born between 1980 and 2000. I was born in 1999, just on the mark. So they are the fastest growing generation in the world. They're the largest. There are 2.5 billion in the world, 80 million in the United States. They are the most technologically savvy. Today I had my PowerPoint presentation on my phone, and I was going through it as I was listening to Kendrick Lamar's Humble on my headphones. You see, the young people are laughing, but the old people are like, what? Who is Kendrick Lamar? You know? And so, why do they matter? In 2020, 50% of the workforce will be millennials. That's in 3 years. 2030, 75% of the millennials will be in the workforce. And now, people who are in their 50s now, in their 30s now, will be pensioners by then. It's really important to take care and take notice into this group of people, these young minds that have been considered to be very, very many things, and see how are we going to be stakeholders in everything. So, Erika, millennials, born between 1980 and 2000, I thought to be very lazy. I love memes. I love memes. When I was preparing my presentation, my uncle came to me and he was like, "Jesse, what are memes?" And for 5 seconds, I was lost because I could not understand how someone would not be able to understand what memes are. I mean, memes are life, that's what people say. Memes are life. And so this is one. A gingerbread man sits in a gingerbread house. Is he made of a house? Or is the house made of him? He does not know. Now, this is not as funny as other memes are, but it has a purpose. The gingerbread man is in an existential crisis. You see, as millennials, as people who are young, we want to make an impact. We want to make a change. Many times we ask ourselves, why am I here? What is my purpose? And so the friends call it raison d'etre. The most important thing, the most important reason for someone to be here. The Japanese call it ikigai. So if you combine both of them, you get something called purpose. Now, I view purpose in relation to food. I mean, how many people love food here? That's everyone, right? So that's a quesadilla. I like Mexican food, spicy, nice. That's donut, chocolate donut, glazed, sprinkles on top. I could eat them all day. But you're probably wondering, why and what does this have to do with purpose? Why does food have to do with something that I will be doing for my life if I don't want to be a chef? You see, I find life like a table of food, where different people come in and sample different types of food. If I like quesadillas, I'll go and eat a quesadilla. If I like donuts, I'll eat a donut. If I like salads, I'll eat a salad. But you see, there are three types of people in this world. There are people who come, and just like me, who like quesadillas, sit down and just eat the quesadilla. There are the people who are philosophers. They say, I'm going to wait for the perfect dish to come. I'm not going to try anything on this table. I'm going to sit down, I'm going to relax, and the perfect dish will come, and I will love it. And then there's a third type of person. The person who samples the quesadilla, moves on and takes a bite of the donut, loves the chicken, loves the beef, loves the salad. Now, the third type of person is the person I would like you to be. There's not only one purpose in life, that is what I've come to find out at the age of 18, I know. Millennial, right? So, people have different things, different interests, different passions. And when my friend comes to his mom and he tells her, I want to be a DJ. And his mom looks at him and is like, no, you have to be a doctor, you have to be a lawyer. She does not know that perhaps later on in life, he could be a DJ, he could be a doctor, he could be a lawyer, he could be what he wants to be. There is not only one purpose for us. This is the Ikigai angle. There you have what you love, your passion, your mission, what you're good at, your profession, what pays you, your vocation, and what the world needs. If you can combine all of that, you have your purpose. But then, the theme of today's talk is why we're here. And the next thing I'm going to talk about is, this is a really good meme. The next thing I'm going to talk about is legacy. Now, why would you use legacy in a topic where what we're talking about is why we're here? It's because what we do now, what we do when we are in this time and space, will define what we will do in the future. You see, our legacy is made by our present. And if we do not confront what is in the now, while we are here, what legacy shall we leave? This is my friend Ali Khan. He is, just like me, 18. He happens to be in the Kenya team for table tennis, and he's now trying for the Kenya team for archery at 18. He spends Monday to Saturday training and practically doesn't have a social life. He has been to Congo, Brazzaville, he has been to Paris, London, just to mention a few. This is my friend Miranda. She plays in 3 orchestras, she coordinates musicals, and she's an actor and maintains a straight A GPA of 3.5. This is my friend Wadai. If you need a man, talk to Wadai. And finally, this is my friend Badet. Now, he does film. He likes making stories. He likes telling stories. Now, you're probably wondering, what do these people have to do with legacy? You see, the thing is, all of them are trying to do something in their own field. They're trying to redefine what it means to be a millennial. We're not lazy. We're not entitled. We are one of the most hardworking people. And I will address that later. But we are leaving a legacy. We are leaving something that will be remembered for. And so that's me. And I'm a photographer, and this is called Magic Movement. I am also passionate about the environment, and I have started a company that basically helps promote environmental awareness through photography. Now, I also want to leave a legacy. I want to stand up and be counted. I want to be known for something. And I think every single person here on this stage or in this room wants to be known for something. How much more? Maybe it's you touched someone's life. Maybe you did something amazing. Maybe the next Mark Zuckerberg, Steve Jobs. Maybe just content with being a good chef. But you still want to be remembered. Why else do we build buildings with people's names or insignias? Why do we have models or statues? Because we all want to be remembered. What legacy will you leave? That's my question. What will you do now that people look back and say, wow, that guy did it? Or what will you say that your children and your children's children will be like, I want to be like grandpa. I want to be like grandma. Millennials, I know. You know when your mom comes and she finds you on your phone and she's like, why are you always on that phone?
I don't.
And you're like, mom, I've just been on it for like 5 minutes. And she's like, why can't you go out and make meaningful connections? The Time magazine described us as a me generation. Millennials are lazy, entitled, narcissists who still live with their parents. Okay, I'm 18. I technically live with my parents, so that's correct. But I'm not lazy, neither am I entitled. And I think that the way we are living and in the generation we are in with technology, you cannot compare the generation X versus us. You see, when you grow up with technology, when you live with people who use Snapchat, I mean, how many people here know what Snapchat is? And I'm looking around and I'm just seeing young people. That's the point. You see, young people are living in a different age. So when I come dressed like this with headphones on, with my kikoi pants and my hat, I'm making a statement. I'm saying that, look, this is not the way things are going to go forward. Things will be different. There will be a difference of opinion. We will do things differently. And that is the generation we are in. We cannot continue to maintain the same heart. Just like in Google, where people walk into the office and they sit with shorts or they sit with sweatpants, so can we. And we can make a difference. Perspective depends on where you're looking from. Now, I think this is very important because the whole thing is perspective. And it's not that people of Generation X are wrong. It's not that people of the millennial generation are right, always. There is a link between them. It is okay to go to the workplace and work your way to the top. It's not right to demand something just because you feel you should. But yet again, it is okay to work using social media, to use Snapchat as a medium of earning business. Why not? Why not think differently? Why not combine two ideas of two different generations and bring them into one? So, if you look at this, from one angle it looks like a six, from the other angle it looks like a nine. And it says, argument is finding out who is right, and discussion is finding out what is right. And this comes out to that meme. It's like, mom, my legs hurt. Because you always got that down for. So, it's basically saying that your parents are going to find a reason as to why you shouldn't be on your phone. It's great. I love cyanide and happiness, best meme page. And you see, it's a free iPod, and mom is like, are you still on the internet? You know, are you still using this thing? But I believe there is hope yet for millennials. I don't think that because we are considered a certain way and that you have lumped a generation with the same characteristics, that is how they are. You see, everyone is different. We are liberal. We are the most ethnically and racially diverse generation yet. We are the people who are changing the way things are being done. And change is scary. But we are the people to take it forward. And if people do not start dialogue or there's no discussion, then Generation X and Generation Millennial will always have this confrontation. And I believe that we can work together and there is future and there is hope for millennials. It's not that serious, right? Thank you.